This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about how to convert between different units of area. I'll deal with units that are in what we call the English system, units like inches, feet, and yards. And I'll also do a problem with the metric system. So here's the first problem. Let's say I've got a rectangle, and its dimensions are 2 feet by 3 feet. And I want to find its area in square inches. Well, I know how to find the area in square feet. I would just multiply the length times the width. So I'd multiply 2 feet by 3 feet, and that would give me 6 square feet. But I want to know how many square inches it is. So here's what I'm going to do. Imagine that I have a square, and its dimensions are 1 foot by 1 foot. If I wanted to know its area, I would just multiply 1 foot by 1 foot, the length times the width, and I would get 1 square foot. Now, 1 foot is the same as 12 inches. So its dimensions could also be written as 12 inches by 12 inches. And so to find out its area in square inches, I would multiply 12 inches by 12 inches. 12 times 12 is 144. So I would have 144 square inches. So 1 foot is equal to 1 square foot is equal to 144 square inches. Let's write that down. 1 square foot equals 144 square inches. I've got 6 feet here, 6 square feet. I want to convert that into square inches. Here's what I'm going to do with it. I'll take the 6 square feet and I'm going to multiply it by this fraction, 144 square inches over 1 square foot. Now let me explain this fraction. I made this fraction based on the equation 1 square foot equals 144 square inches. If the numerator of a fraction is equal to the denominator of a fraction, then that fraction equals 1. And because of this equation, I know that the numerator and the denominator are equal to each other. So I'm just taking my 6 square feet and multiplying them by a fraction equal to 1. Because of the way I wrote the fraction, I can now cancel out the square feet from the denominator of the fraction and from the 6 square feet that I have. And then all I have is 6 times 144 square inches. 6 times 144 is 864. So that means my rectangle that I started with would have an area of 864 square inches. Let's try another one with yards. So let's say that this time I've got a rectangle again, and the dimensions of this rectangle are 8 feet by 15 feet, and I want to know how many square yards I have. Well, I can find out the number of square feet. That would be 8 feet times 15 feet, or 120 square feet. Now I want to find out the relationship between square feet and square yards. So once again, I'm going to think of myself as having a square, which is 1 yard by 1 yard. I know that that's going to be 1 square yard, its area. I also know that 1 yard is the same as 3 feet. So it means its dimensions are 3 feet by 3 feet. If I multiply those two dimensions, the length and the width, I'll get 9 square feet. So now I can write the equation. 1 square yard equals 9 square feet. I'll take the number of square feet I have for this rectangle that I started with. That was 120 square feet. And I'll multiply it by 1. The version of what I'm going to use is going to be 1 square yard over 9 square feet. Now I can cancel out the square feet, and I'm going to have 120 over 9 square yards. Now simplify this fraction. 120 and 9 are both divisible by 3, so that's going to be 40 over 3. And I'll turn that into a mixed number. So that's going to be 13 and 1/3 square yards. Okay, let's do one with the metric system. So for the metric system, I'll be dealing with meters. Let's do meters and centimeters. So let's say I've got this rectangle, and it's 3 meters by 4 meters, and I want its area in square centimeters. I know that its area is going to be 12 square meters. I'm just multiplying the length times the width, 3 times 4, and I get 12 square meters. I want to know how many square centimeters. So I'll find out what the relationship is between square meters and square centimeters. If I have a square that's 1 meter by 1 meter, its area is 1 square meter. 1 meter is the same as 100 centimeters. So that means that the area would be 100 centimeters times 100 centimeters, or 10,000 square centimeters. Let's write that equation over here. So 1 square meter equals 10,000 square centimeters. Now I'll take the area of the rectangle, which was 12 square meters, and I'll multiply that by my fraction equal to 1, which is going to be 10,000 square centimeters over 1 square meter. The square meters will cancel out. I just have to multiply 12 times 10,000. That's going to be 120,000, and my units are square centimeters. Okay, so I hope this helps. Take care. I'll see you next time.